You know, when I was studying, I studied in the You Can Live Forever in Paradise book, and I learned, and many other people learned, that the generation of 1914 was just, one generation of people who saw or who were living in the times of 1914 and were observant of the times and, would live up until the time of the end. Now, this is taken from the Live Forever book, and it's page 154. And notice this here: Armageddon. Some of the generation living in 1914 will see the end of the system of things and survive it. And let me read this paragraph to you. After drawing attention to the many things that have marked the period from 1914 onward, Jesus said, "This generation will by no means pass away until all these things, including the end of the system, occur." Which generation did Jesus mean? He meant the generation of people who were living in 1914. Those persons yet remaining of that generation are now very old. However, some of them will still be alive to see the end of the wicked system. So of this we can be certain. Shortly now, this was 1982, shortly now, there will be a sudden end to all wickedness and wicked people at Armageddon. Shortly now. That was 1982. So in my mindset, I thought, hey, it's got to be close. It's near its end, because there's still some of that generation left. So if a witness gets that whole meaning into their mind and heart set, they're naturally going to think, well, there is. It's only a short amount of time left. But now here it is, 2010, and the society has changed the meaning and the context, just totally flip-flopped it around, and it's not even this same meaning now. It's anointed persons whose lives overlap. Something's fishy, folks, and it stinks royally big time. And instead of the governing bodies saying that light is truly getting brighter, Jehovah is refining his organization. It's crap. It's crap. They need to fully explain why things or a meaning has been changed. Okay? Instead of just, it's like an illustration of holding a carrot out in front of a horse. You've probably seen a cartoon of that, with a stick and a carrot dangling over the top of the head of a horse. That's just what they're doing to witnesses today. They're leading them on. Okay? And one other thing I meant to point out in that last one was this article was, it was put out, like I said, by the World Magazine, and that was a magazine back in that time. And they want you to believe that even a worldly magazine. Don't you just love that term, worldly? Kind of leaves a bad taste in your mouth. Worldly. That even they were saying that times were bad at that time. It goes on to say here. Let me get my enlargement copy here. That's from that week. According to the calculations of Reverend Russell's International Bible Students, this is the time of trouble spoken of by the prophet Daniel. The year 1914 predicted in the book The Time Is at Hand, that was a book at that time, of which 4 million copies have been sold as the date of the downfall of the kingdoms of the earth. Now, this is what they really want you to see here. The terrific war outbreak in Europe has fulfilled an extraordinary prophecy. Look out for 1914. Okay. But they don't show you the whole article, and it's really going in, and there's like a chart here. They don't want you to, it's like they don't want you to see what the article actually says. They only want you to see, the society only wants you to see this. They only want you to see The terrific war outbreak in Europe has fulfilled an extraordinary prophecy. They only want you to see that. So, I'm hoping that witnesses will see these videos and do a little bit of thinking. Do your own little research, especially on the topic 1914. And just realize that, think to yourself, what is going on? Why is the governing body doing this? Why are they changing the meaning and the context? They need to fully explain it. Why? And don't use the excuse that Jehovah is refining his organization. The light is truly getting brighter. Those two sayings are really getting old. And they really need to fully explain it and come up with an explanation why.